So what I'm hoping to tackle today is a mouse. I have a copy of Cute Mouse on floppy. I hit my favorite surplus computer place and was able to find several serial mice. Here's an old Microsoft 2 button. A Tandy 2 button serial. A Microsoft Home 2 button, again serial. A Genius 3 button serial. Some kind of a touchpad, again serial. A Monster Trackball, again serial. And what I believe to be a PS2 card for serial mouse. It's made by Logitech. It's about got to be a PS2 serial mouse card. I paid less than $1 per mouse for the mice. The trackball, and they got a whole box of stuff for $35. It included a laptop, another motherboard, and ISA cards, and software, and a ton of stuff. Anyhow, let's see if the system will still boot, and see if we can make Cute Mouse work. Hopefully it's still bootable. The other thing that I got was memory. So we will tackle additional memory. Yeah, the CMOS options aren't set. Let me turn on the power supply. Get power to the backup battery and we'll go ahead and set up the CMOS again. I've really got to get a battery on here. So it's a type 47 16383. Heads was 16 and sectors was 63. Let me take a peek here, see if I can, if I'm remembering right. 63, 16, 16, 383. Yep, that's correct. This is a 1.44 meg, and this is a 1.2. Should now boot from the hard drive. And there we go. I completely forgot about Cute Mouse till I hit the web looking for mouse driver software. And Cute Mouse popped up, and I thought, I remember Cute Mouse from way back in the day. We've booted. Untangle the cord on this mouse now that I've got the wire tie off of it. I should be able to go directly into what I believe is COM1 here. So we're into COM1 down here. Let's make working in Windows a lot easier if this works. Get to the A floppy. I think it's CT mouse. It should go out this version in auto detect. Installed at COM1 in Microsoft mode. Perfect. We should now have a Windows mouse if this mouse works. Yeah, I picked up another Sound Blaster card. Just a bunch of stuff in today's haul. And the laptop is going to be a pretty sweet little machine, I think. But we'll look at it in a different video. So right now, I'll just be excited if this mouse actually works. So far, no. Oh. I saw it do something there. We saw it do something briefly. So, I don't know if Cute Mouse works under Windows or not. Well, file. So, end your Windows session. Trying to think if I have any software on here DOS-wise to test. Boot. They've got the Microsoft mouse driver on there as well, supposedly. That should work with Windows 3.1. So it's always an adventure. What do you mean hard disk drive? Controller failure. I don't believe that. Cycle the power. Which, of course, is the reason I turned the power supply on that's playing battery backup for the CMOS. And this old electronics is fidgety. Floppy was actually in the drive. Mouse 901. Supposedly this is the Windows mouse driver, or the Microsoft mouse driver. Unzip file. Yep. Oh, interesting. Okay, hopefully there's enough room on this disk for this. I should have done this on the hard drive. Oh well. I doubt I can abort it. Of course, I just noticed it's 600 and something K. Well, hopefully I'm not going to corrupt the floppy booting in the middle of the unzip. Also picked up a little El Cheapo joystick, so I can maybe do some classic gaming on here, but that will be another video. Yeah, we're getting quite the stack of drivers on here. Sorry about all the noise in the microphone. Hopefully it'll be better here. As you can tell from my videos, I'm still trying to figure out audio. I need to move the camera mount to a tripod off of the actual desk I'm working on. Lots of things to do. leave it to Microsoft to have a ton of pieces of software for a mouse driver. I know there was a setup. That helps. I'm guessing this will all fit on one floppy. I know, it's as much fun as watching paint dry. Page down. Windows NT support. Set mouse, mouse slash actually. Let's exit this. F3 is exit. See if we can run setup from the hard drive. Setup from Windows in your system. Running setup from Windows is a preferred method. Would you like to go to Windows? We'll exit and we'll do it from. Yeah, let's go ahead and let it do its thing. Why not? See if they've automated this inside of Windows 3.1.1 somehow. No clue what it's doing. Obviously, it's starting Windows. Continue. No devices attached. Exit. We will try an actual Microsoft mouse here. Not that I think it should make a difference, but maybe, who knows? It's able to identify a Microsoft mouse. So here's a Microsoft Home mouse. The wire tie and plug this guy in. Yeah, the serial port is connected to the PCB, so the good old days when simply getting a driver loaded could take all afternoon. As you know, computers were there to make our lives easier. Same exercise. Go to Windows. Now I'm gonna try cute mouse again. Hold the file. Exit. Again, I don't know if DOS mouse drivers work under Windows. Part of me says they should, part of me knows they won't. CT mouse. It's installed at the right place. I mean, it's COM1. I think it's the only, well, there's two serial ports on the machine, but I'm assuming I'm in COM1. Now I'm curious. Oops. Resident part set to COM1. So it is, that there tells me that it is seeing a mouse. In Microsoft mode. And it's a Microsoft mouse. Did QBasic support a mouse? I don't remember. Oh, well, we do have a mouse. And we definitely have a mouse. That's a good sign. At least we know the mouse works and we've got the right serial port. Is it accessing the floppy? Just hung it up. I don't know. Nope. I had a mouse. I remember how this works. The mouse is to run Windows setup to install the mouse. Ah. Okay. Alt settings. Exit. And then I saw Windows setup. Oh, there it is. Remove Windows components. These are all installed. Do they mean Windows Setup from floppy? I don't know. Change system settings. Well, that certainly wasn't what I wanted. Options, system settings. It's actually looking for an OEM setup. So what I really need to do is get the DOS driver to see a mouse. Let's go ahead and reboot. I am determined to try to boot off a non-startable floppy every time. I'm just going to do it without license to continue Windows and DOS. Actually, let's exit. So it wants to install to a mouse folder, and that would make sense. Microsoft mouse plugged in. Let's just run setup from here. Continue, continue, continue. Windows and MS-DOS to see mouse as the install location. Load mouse driver automatically at power up. Here's Cute Mouse, that tiny little driver, and here's the Windows mouse driver with lots and lots of files. Of course, it's going to install under Windows, apparently, with DLLs, so. I recommend you run Mouse Manager. Yeah, sure, let's run it, see what we get. Well, speed-wise and DOS seems okay. call this okay. Restart the machine. I would expect now at DOS to see a mouse driver load. I didn't see. Oh, it did. Well, okay, we know the driver loaded. When? Yay, we have a Windows mouse. This will make playing a lot easier. Mouse manager. All of these crazy. Assume it's loading sound delay. File open. I don't know if we have any WAV files anyplace on the system. I seriously doubt it. I do know there's at least one MIDI file someplace. Excuse me. I should be able to now actually to, let's see, eject. Minimized it. Samples. How do I add to the playlist? Do I drag and drop it? Oh, select them and then click add, obviously. Done. Done. Turn power on to the speakers. Mouse is dirty. on this little 386 is struggling to keep up. I'm looking for the way to set the volume. The lag is rather astonishing here. Well, there you have it. Getting a Microsoft Home mouse working on my Windows 3.1.1 machine. So, hopefully there was some entertainment in this, and we'll talk soon. Bye.